how she get it. Made a couple racks, I never asked how she did it. City girls out of have fun in the city. City girls out of have fun. Welcome to Connect with Christina, episode 15, season 2. Can you believe that? Season 2.
That's awesome.
This beautiful girl next to me, I have to say, she's so dope. Her name is Shannon. She's going to talk to you guys in a minute. She's from Chicago, and now she's part of our awesome Arizona family. We have an interesting topic today. We're going to talk about cheating. Sorry, guys. But
dun, 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 dun.
Dun, dun, dun. But before that, I have to share that she is as lovely on the inside as she is on the outside. And I always talk about the positivity of the DMs. She's one of them. She slid in my DM and we became friends. Then I found out that she was super passionate about helping a lot of elderly people in the insurance space. And we're not going to talk about that, but I will say she reminded me that you guys out there, before you sign anything, read your contract.
Always read.
Also, she's a fitness competitor. I think it's natural bikini competitor, right?
Sure, we'll go with that.
I feel like there's a proper title. Jay Dang would be mad at me. What is it? What's like, the actual title?
I'm pretty sure it's bikini bodybuilder.
Okay, yeah. We'll go with that.
We'll go with that.
And soon you will find her, hopefully, at Five Star Fitness as your new trainer. So be looking out for that. We'll put up her Instagram. Please don't stalk her.
You can stalk me. Don't come to my house.
Hey, but seriously, though, thank you for, you know, I have three daughters, so I admire you being a brave young woman that, you know, who moved from Chicago out here the way that you did. And I also want to shout you out for one of my favorite things about you is I happened to find out that this girl right here let another friend of mine who really, she didn't really know, let her stay in her condo in Chicago. Like, that's my person.
Yeah.
So thank you for being who you are.
Thanks.
And now we get to go to the crazy part of this podcast today. Yeah. Have you ever been cheated on?
Lots of times. I don't want to say a lot. Maybe.
No, not a lot. So what?
Three.
Like, three times
four,
that you
four.
Can. Okay.
Do we count high school relationships?
No, let's leave that out. Let's. How about we just talk about the recent one? So, like, walk us through that.
Oh, Lord. Where do I start?
Actually, if there's four, we really need to, like, look into all four.
I think it's me.
You know,
I don't know.
The fact that you even said that, again, isn't she a wonderful person? No, let's try to decipher that. After you tell me, maybe I'll tell you if you're the common denominator here. But let's see. When was the first time?
First time was when I was 20.
Okay, so, like, walk us through that. We have time.
Okay. So the first time was we were dating for, like,
remember, don't leave anything out because this episode was sponsored today by Jeannie Teyachea, Opportunity to Own. So she couldn't make the podcast, so she's like, you know, I think I'm just going to start sponsoring people that come on. So that's why we brought you on, because we want to tell your story and help people that go through, you know, we're laughing, but cheating isn't fun. Like, it really does, you know, can cause mental health and stress and emotional pain. So I'm just thankful you're willing to be that person to talk about this topic because it is very painful. So,
yeah. So I think we dated for, it was like more like, I want to say 6 months to a year. It was like on and off.
Okay.
But it was like still consistent because I wasn't talking to anybody else. And I thought he wasn't talking to anyone else. We dated. And I should have known red flag because he's a stripper.
Okay.
But
we're taking notes, right? Because at the end, if it's really her, we're going to tell. I'm just kidding. Okay.
So, I mean, like, what, you just, like, want to know, like, the whole thing?
Yeah, like,
just,
so
like,
what
when
happened?
I caught.
Yeah, so what, first of all, you didn't have, like, an open relationship. It was really a relationship and you thought you were exclusive, right? Because that's how you call it cheating, is if you thought
well,
you were just
I don't know, like, you know, like, new generation, there's like different levels of dating. There's like talking, dating exclusive, and then exclusive, apparently. I don't know.
And then open relationship.
Yeah, so.
And then some other polyamorous stuff. Right. Gatsby, you would know something about that. not from you, but from your friends. So, okay, so let's just go with you thought it was exclusive. And so you were dating 6 months, okay.
Yeah, you know.
And you thought it was going well. So
I really didn't have boyfriends in high school.
Was he the same age?
No.
Okay.
He was like 28, 29.
Okay, okay.
So like 8, 9 years apart. I don't know. I like older men, I guess. I don't know what's wrong with me. But
there's nothing wrong with you. You like what you like.
Yeah, yeah. So we were dating, like I'd even go to like his stripping, like parties.
Wow, this is juicy.
Like I would go and like sit in the corner and like play the music for him while he performed. Like while he performed, like at people's houses and stuff. Like,
oh, okay. Okay.
And like drive around, like he'd go to different states and I would like go with him. So I was like, I'm like, we're spending all this time together. He'd come wait for me at work because I worked at Hooters then too. So, I mean, one night he had asked me to make him a German chocolate cake.
Okay.
And I made it, and I had fell asleep, so I was like, I'm going to drop it off in the morning. And he's like, okay. I guess he forgot I was dropping the cake off. And I walked into his house, and he was in bed with another girl. And I was with my puppy at the time. And the girl, like, tried to, when I, like, left, she tried to run over my dog. So I followed her.
Hold up. Wait a minute. Hold on. So you walked in. They were in bed, like.
Sleeping.
Because
it was the morning. Yeah.
So they had clothes on, no clothes on. Sorry, I like details.
No clothes.
Okay.
Like full-blown titties.
Okay. So there, you walk in on that. So when did they wake up and when did you wake them up? Or when did they realize you were in the room?
When I poured water on him.
Okay. Okay, so that's number one. And then she tried to run out your dog over. No dogs deserve to be run over.
No, he was only like 4 months. No. She was like, I don't know why she tried to run him over, but I literally followed her because I guess she had to go meet her mom at like breakfast or something.
Mm-hmm.
And I followed her to the breakfast place and like called her out. Like they had to call security and everything. Because like I didn't even care about like him cheating. I cared about her running over my dog.
Well, and also there's a girl code too. And like, yeah. I was talking to a friend of mine about this. Like, there has, you know, like, because if you're a girl's girl, you know the girl's code and you don't do stuff like that. But we won't go into that. That's another episode. So, number two. So, what played out in number two?
Number two.
Let me, was he a stripper?
No.
Okay.
Number two.
Sorry, we're just keeping it real.
Number two was someone that I talked to for a while. We were like on and off because he still lived in Chicago and I lived here. And he was like begging me to like be in a relationship. And I was
come
like,
closer to the mic,
oh,
please.
Sorry.
It's okay.
I was like, no, like, because you live in Chicago, like, and you're traveling to Florida. Like, I don't know what you're doing. You know, he's like, you know, I'm not hooking up with anyone. Like, I only talk to you. Like, and I'm like, we'll see when you come here. We'll talk about it. So, my 21st birthday, he flew me to Chicago for my birthday, and he told me at dinner that he was hooking up with his ex, and she was pregnant.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. So that's how this number two. So the whole time, did he say?
The whole time.
And oh, okay. Mm-hmm. And how long were you dating him?
I met him when I was 18, mm-hmm. but we were like,
Friends,
like on and off, like because I didn't live there, so like I didn't take it seriously. Mm-hmm. But we didn't like start being serious until after the whole stripper dude. but yeah, so that was.
But
I mean,
did you
it was
have
a great
like
way
an
to bring in my birthday.
Did you have like an instinct at all? Did you have a gut feeling or like, wow? I mean, it's one thing that he told you.
Yeah. So when he had asked me to like to be official, we had went to Vegas together. And Vegas just, it was not a good trip. Like, he was drunk most of the time. I drove up to Vegas to go see him, and I literally waited in the lobby for 10 hours.
Oh, my God.
Because he was like, I'm coming. Like, just wait in the lobby. Because they wouldn't let me into the room because my name wasn't in the room.
Red flag.
And I was like, where are you? Like, I'm about to go home. Like, I just drove 4.5 hours up here. He's like, I my business meeting ran late. Like,
business meeting.
Business meeting. I was like, I can't get into the hotel room, and I wasn't 21 yet. So,
oh,
like,
gosh.
I had a fake.
Oh, gosh.
But, like, I was scared to use it.
We'll cut that out of that.
It's too late now. I'm already past 21. But I was, like, scared to use, like, you know, the ID to, like, get a room. Because I thought you had to be 21 to get a room. I didn't know you could be 18. Mm-hmm. So he's like, just get a room, and just, like, I'll pay for it when we check out or whatever. And I'm like, but you already have a room. Why would I get another room? I was like, why can't you just come meet me and let me into the room and go back and do whatever you're doing? And he was like, I can't leave this meeting, blah, blah, blah. So they let me get the room with my, like, fake.
Okay.
So I don't know how I got past that.
She's all hesitant with my fake.
And he didn't come back into the room until 3 a.m. And before he came back into the, when he, like, fell asleep, I went on Snapchat, and he was in the hotel the whole time.
Oh, my.
He was at the Aria, at the whatever club that is in the Aria. I don't know what club that is.
Oh, the one downstairs.
The one downstairs. Yeah, he was in the hotel room the whole time.
Oh, my God.
The whole time. And I'm like, are you serious? You were here the whole time. You could have just came upstairs.
And you forgot to block her on Snapchat. I'm
yeah, like you.
Guys, cheating is too much work. Don't
it
do
is,
it.
Especially when you're drunk. And on other things, but
other than it's wrong, it's a lot of work. Don't do it. Okay.
Literally. So from there, like, it kind of, like, fizzled. Like, the trip just went not good because I was mad the whole time because I drove all the way up there.
Right.
And like, had to sit in the lobby.
Right.
So that was kind of my inkling because we weren't talking as much. And then when it got closer to my birthday, he's like, things have been, like, kind of weird. Like, I really want to work on it. Like, I want to bring you home for your birthday, like, because I know you want to see your family and everything, and it's your 21st, and I was like, okay, and then that's when he told me at dinner on my birthday.
So what was your reaction then?
Honestly, I wasn't even surprised.
So, but when he told you, did he, like, dance around it, or was he, like, just straight up?
He waited until we got our steak. This is when I did eat steak, because I don't eat
You gotta
steak,
have
really.
The steak first.
Yeah, he waited till we, like, were in, like, full into dinner to tell me that. He was like, I have something to tell you. And I'm like, go ahead. Like, I already just, like, was expecting something.
The big question is, did you finish the steak?
I did. I had dessert, too.
Okay.
And then I was like, because my family didn't know I was home yet because I was going to surprise them the next day. So I was like, no, just call me an Uber. Like, I want to go home now. Like, just send me to my mom's house.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so the third one?
The third one was recent.
Okay. Wait, there's the third and the fourth. So the third one
was, like, kind of, it happened, like, a few months ago.
Okay, so this third one, like, what category is that? Like, exclusive? Like, what is it?
The third one was completely exclusive, like, meeting each other's families and intertwining lives.
Okay. Yeah. So serious.
Yeah. That one, I should have knew it was a red flag.
Tell us.
Personal,
what did
I just have the worst
what was local, the red flag?
Personal trainers are just red flags sometimes. Like, I swear they have, because they have so many beautiful women around them, and it's, like, so much temptation. Like, I get, if I was a dude, I'd get it. Like, I understand. Like, I get it. But
you're not allowed to say that. No, if you, that you're to stay single.
Yeah. And
choose
be honest.
To stay single, be transparent, be honest. Okay, I don't care if you're a personal trainer and you're the hottest thing and you're around the hottest, you know, kind of women. You don't do that. So you can't say that because you cannot give them permission to do that. No, if that's the case and you're this, you know, cute, whatever, trainer and you're around women, clients and other trainers, you are not meant to be in a relationship. You need to be single and that's it. And no one's going to be mad at you for that.
Yeah. Okay, no, I'm not going to call all personal trainers, though.
Yeah.
There's a lot of good ones that are actually faithful.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to call it only the one that I dated.
There you go.
It should have been a red flag.
So she retracted that.
I retract my statement.
It's the one she dated.
Yeah.
Because you're right. I mean, I have friends that are personal trainers that are family people, that are faithful boyfriends, girlfriends. So you're right. It's just this
certain percentage.
Yeah. So, okay, continue.
It wasn't even intended to, like, be anything, like, serious until we were going to Mexico.
Okay.
And I paid for the trip.
Red flag. Continue.
That should have been the red flag. It was supposed to be for his birthday.
Okay, and then maybe.
It was like a combined, like my birthday, his birthday, and my graduation, even though it probably should have still been him paying for
it. By the way, congratulations. You graduated ASU?
Yeah.
What?
Geography and urban planning.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Congrats.
We went to Mexico. We had a great time. And we come back, and I went to Chicago a couple days later. And I found out that he hit up some girl on Instagram and, like, literally took her on a date the day I flew out to Chicago. Like, we weren't even there. We weren't even back here 48 hours, and he was already hitting up a girl to go on a date.
Wait, how did you find out?
He brought the girl to a Labor Day party a couple months later. I didn't find out until months later, but he brought her to a party that we were both at. He invited her. He didn't bring her.
So while you were traveling or flying to this trip that you paid for, mm-hmm. he was messing with another girl.
Yeah, he was talking to another girl.
Okay. And then, but you didn't find out until how many months later?
That was in May. So September, like three, is that 3 months?
Okay. Oh. So, and how did you find out?
We literally went to someone's house, a pool party for Labor Day weekend. And he was like, oh, my friend's coming up. Like, I invited my friend. I'm thinking it's, like, his roommate, because he had asked his roommate before we left to come. And it was some girl that showed up, and I'd never seen her before. And one of his friends that was there, whose house it was like, oh, hey, I remember you. You were on the boat for Memorial Day weekend. And that was the week I had left to Chicago. And I was like, you told me you're on the boat with your college buddies. What do you mean you brought a girl on the boat? She's like, no, he brought a couple girls. I was like, oh.
Okay, even better.
Just keep adding them in there. I'm like, oh, okay. I was like, after we came back from Mexico? She's like, yeah, yeah. I was like, oh, okay.
So you talked to him about it? Did you, like, confront him? Okay, so let's just say you had the conversation. Just be careful. I'm not cutting
it. I had to, like, do some investigation first to, like, find out that they were, like, hanging out.
Right.
And she eventually told me, like, I hit her up on Instagram and was like, hey, like, we're dating. Like, we're in a relationship. Like, who are you? And she literally told me everything. She told me everything. She was like, he hit me up on Instagram. I told him I like boats, and he, like, took me on this cute date. And then he asked me Memorial Day weekend if I wanted to go on a boat because I love boats. And he said he bought a boat for the weekend, for Memorial Day weekend.
He bought a boat.
Yeah. Okay. And I'm like, oh, he paid for the boat? You sure? and she's like, yeah, yeah. And I'm like, oh, okay. She's like, yeah, me and my friend were on there, and we were dating. She said they were dating for a month and a half. And I'm like, well, how are you guys dating for a month and a half? Because I came back home, and I literally was with them every day. And she was like, no, I was over, like, all the time. I was like, oh.
How does that happen? I didn't have the time to do that. This guy is talented. Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh. Mm-hmm. Okay, so but when you actually confronted him, was he apologetic? Was he sorry? Did he try to bring you back? Did he say, like, he made a mistake? Like, what was that conversation?
So I didn't, like, confront him right away. I had to do some investigation. Okay. And I found that there were more girls. It wasn't just her.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It was
more. Got it.
A lot. Got
And then you got yourself checked after, right? Because that's you should.
I did. Okay. I did. Yeah, so that's, I'm like trying.
Did he apologize?
It didn't pan out. Like it wasn't like a, oh, sit down conversation. Like, it was like other things happened in reaction to it. And then that information came out.
Okay.
So, and no, he didn't take responsibility for anything. He said that we weren't dating. And I was like, yes, we were. You literally flew to another state to go meet my parents and stayed in their house. And if anyone has a black mom, they know. You don't have dudes come and just stay at the house. Like, my mom was like, no, you can go get a hotel. He's not staying here. And she finally, like, budged and let him stay for one day. Mm-hmm. So, like, and he met, like, my closest friends, like, my coworkers. He met my stepdad. So I was like, I don't know what do you mean we weren't dating? Like, I literally am having breakfast with your mom every weekend, and we're working out together. Like, and him, my mom and his mom were, like, hanging out when she would come out for my competitions.
I think it's crazy that on top of you having to educate us on this, the generation's level of relationship, that it seems like you also have to have a conversation of that. Are we actually in a relationship?
Yeah.
But obviously, in that case, yeah, you were definitely in a relationship, and he was just cheating.
My family didn't even meet my prom date. I don't bring dudes around, like, unless I'm, like, really serious about them. He was the first one I'd brought around. So, wow. Like, it was, like, really annoying because I'm, like, I don't let my family get intertwined. And for you to sit here and say that we aren't dating, like,
right?
What do you mean?
So. Okay, so he never took responsibility.
Nope, and never apologized.
Wow, mm-hmm. Okay. Number four, and you know, guys, after this, it's that number four is the last. No one is gonna do this to you again. I promise you that.
I'm a reborn again. number four was recent. We were dating for like a month and a half.
Okay.
And that one, I really don't even know like what happened, but my family was in town, and we went to Chauncey Social, mm-hmm. and we sat down, and we were eating, and they looked over, and they were like, isn't that so-and-so? And I'm like, oh, it is. And then I saw who he was with, and I was like, oh, and it was a girl. And he had, like, his hand around her and stuff, and I'm like, wow. So I walked up to him and confronted him. And he's like, you're following me. I'm like,
oh, my God.
I was like, I'm here with my family, like, there's like two 17-year-old boys over here, like, I'm eating dinner with. Like, no one's following you. What are you talking about? And he was like, yes, you are. I'm like, I didn't even know you were here. Like, what are you talking about? Like, you're crazy. And he was like, no, you're crazy. Like, he turned it completely around on me. And I'm like, okay, no one taking responsibility.
So then after that was the confrontation, and that was done?
Like, you haven't thought? Okay. No, we don't. Nothing was said after that. Like,
so, but I have to ask you. So you were dating for like a month and a half. So mm-hmm. It wasn't a full blown relationship, but you guys thought, or were you like exclusive? Like, was that talked about?
I wasn't talking to anyone. He said he wasn't talking to anyone. Like, he would literally take me around like his coworkers and like to church and be like, this is my girl, my goddess.
He took you where?
To church.
Okay.
Oh. and he would like introduce me as his
girl
or he'll say goddess or queen or whatever. Mm-hmm. So that's, to me, that's claiming someone.
See, so we need to have like a guy's perspective on that, you know?
Yeah.
Because mm-hmm. like, I mean, on the fourth one, I'm just saying that because there's no excuse for cheating or treating anyone, guy or girl, that way. Mm-hmm. But it's interesting to me as far as like, you know, because it was just a month and a half, you know? And like mm-hmm. I said, there's no excuse for that because you were under the understanding that you were in a relationship, you know?
Yeah.
But don't you want to, like, figure out what goes through a guy's mind?
I would love to know. I just think there's so many rules.
Gatsby, do you have anything to say?
No. I don't even think sometimes dudes even really know, to be honest.
I will say, okay, so I think, you know, one episode I had Jordan, my friend, on here, and we were talking about like ways or like clues on cheating, and we had to be like, look, we're not teaching you how to cheat, but these are the clues, you know, and we broke it down like down to like today, yesterday, because we were shooting for a content, and yesterday he came up with the newest thing on, you know, that people are doing when they're hiding like them cheating is they will put the phone number in their phone as likely a scam.
Oh,
so I was like, what? Who thinks of these things?
That's so, like someone putting it as like their mom.
Right. And wow. That, you know, and that happens. Like, they put their boss, their mom, their whatever it is.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
No, you have to, like, watch that actual episode. But my point is, there's men like this guy walking back, like, back and forth, Scott. He's a devoted husband, you know. But I think, like, there's some character that comes into play. Like, I, my opinion only, and I'm entitled to my opinion. I think that there's, just like with women and with men too, like, there's a certain breed that is just okay with doing stuff like that. And then there's the certain kind of breed where they just, it's not in their DNA to be able to do it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I think there's like, we have to try to decipher some of the red flags that come with that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because people that are capable of doing that, they're capable of doing so much more, you know?
Mm.
So obviously, like, well, tell me, as a woman, like, how do you feel about the last four? Like, what do you feel about that? Like, as you,
I honestly feel like either I'm just like oblivious to the red signs, or I just keep accepting, like, that's just who they are. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that's why I said I feel like it's me, because I'm accepting the behavior.
Okay, well, and I respect you for, like, holding yourself accountable, because that's how you grow. Mm-hmm. You're beautiful, and you're beautiful inside. And, like, seriously, like, you help anyone that needs help. Like, I know that about you.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, you're still so young, too.
Mm-hmm.
So I think, like, just take the last four and tell yourself, like, no, you're not going to allow that ever again, but you will take the lessons from it, you know? And, I mean, you have a career, you have all this stuff happening. Like, my suggestion as Christina Oprah today is just, why don't you date yourself for a while?
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. Like, I'm literally saying, go on your trips by yourself without meeting someone in Miami or here.
Yeah.
Go on those trips by yourself. Go on a date by yourself, like, go to a movie. Have you ever gone to a movie by yourself?
All the time. That's what I was doing before I met the one I was in the longest relationship with. After the guy that cheated, like, told me about him cheating on mm-hmm. me on my birthday, I hadn't dated anyone after that for a long time. So I didn't date anyone for like 3 years. And then, well, almost 3 years. And I was dating myself. Like, it was just me and my dog.
Right.
It was my dog was my boyfriend.
And yeah, and I think, like, because you're not, you know, don't be looking for it either. Mm-hmm. Which, if you're not, it's gonna come to you. But I say, dedicate with your new projects. Like, date your new project.
Yeah.
Date your new. You're about to be part of the 5-star fam, and you're about to be like this awesome trainer. Like, date your career.
Yeah.
And then the right person who's also dating their goals, that person will meet you there. I often talk about my daughters. I love them, and they're, you know, being raised as really strong, powerful, independent little young ladies. You know, they have a good father, an amazing dad, and then as an example, and then Kevin's around us, and he's great. So I always kind of refer to them a lot, because I want to raise them the best way that I can, that mm-hmm. we can. So I think, like, part of the thing I tell them when I get the opportunity is, you know, in a relationship with the person that you have in front of you, it needs to be someone that you can build with, not something that you have to fix.
Exactly.
You know, because mm-hmm. it's just a dead end.
Yeah.
You know, so I think that your future after this 4 cheating situations is going to change. And because you will no longer be looking for the guy, you know, the right guy will come. However, there is an app. It's called Farah, and I'm only bringing it up because it's my good friend's new app. It's,
okay.
And you saw it on Instagram. It's I think it's like Join Farah. Anyway, it's Zach and Ian Kirshner, and they created this app that they want to change, like, the way you date people.
Okay.
Because of this, like, they want to try to avoid toxic experiences
mm-hmm.
and. To where I think the app is built so that, yeah, okay, you met this person, and maybe you're not going to date this person, but you just literally met a new friend.
Yeah.
You know? So it's like a literal, like, more safe, like a safer resource for dating.
So more like start out friends.
Yeah.
And then, like,
yeah, just like get to know them. And, you know, I think, well, of course, I didn't download the app. I'm in a happy relationship, so I couldn't tell you how it works, but you should download it, and then I'll introduce you to them so that, like, you should talk to these boys because they're awesome. And I think the other thing is just, you'll agree with this, surround yourself with good people.
Yeah, good people, good energy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have anything to say about this, Gatsby? Because
No comment, I guess. No, I've definitely learned. I honestly, right now, the rest of the year, at least, I'm not trying to date anybody. Just me and my dog.
If I find out she's dating, we're going to bring her back on here. Just FYI.
I'm not. Like, my heart and mental, like, I've done so much Reiki.
Are you grounded and concentrated? What is that called?
I'm trying to be grounded and concentrated. I'm, like, getting back on my wagon of being independent and being by myself and not, like, having my life intertwined with somebody else. So just finding my new hobbies and just relearning and redating myself and like building my own self.
Well, we're gonna revisit because I believe in you and you're gonna do it. And also, like, honestly, we're joking around in this podcast. I already said that, yeah, don't be a cheater. Like, that's for people who are weak, so don't do that. And obviously good people make mistakes too, so that's not who I'm talking about. Because people do make mistakes, and if they learn, then you know, that's a good thing. But I'm talking about, like, the people that live by this, that it's okay. Like, it's a constant, they're always constantly hurting other men or other women. That is not okay.
I think that's more of, honestly, I think those people don't actually realize what they're doing, or they're, like, serial.
And I think they're broken inside. Yeah. And but
it's like something else, it's something deeper, and that's why they do that.
And as a mom, you know, I pray for my kids, and those are the things that I never want them to have to feel ever. Yeah. You know, I don't want them to do it to someone else, and I don't want them to feel that pain, you know?
Yeah.
And so, but as a whole, like, you coming on here talking about this, and we're joking about it, like, there's nothing, you know, like, be proud, because there's nothing embarrassing about that. Like,
I'm not embarrassed. Honestly, all those men taught me something. Like, I'm not trying to be Ariana Grande, but thank you, next. So, like, you know, like, honestly, like, all of them had me grow in certain ways in different points of my life, and, like, opened up new things. So at the end of the day, like, I'm still grateful that I met them. I don't communicate with any of them. Maybe one of them I still communicate with, but not like that.
Yeah, and you're going to move past that. But what I was more referring to is, like, anyone watching, like, if you even have any judgment in your bone right now, you shouldn't be following me and you shouldn't be watching this, because this is, like, for the good people out here that, like, we all, like, share this community together, you know? So I'm super proud of you for coming on here.
Thanks for having me.
For sharing your story. And being brave about it, and your future is so bright, you know.
Thank you.
So
I appreciate it.
Yeah, and she'll be back, because she's also she's a busybody. And line up if you want to start training with her soon. Catch her at 5-star, but don't catch feelings, okay?
Well, I gotta get there first.
Yeah,
I gotta finish.
Or manifesting by the time
manifesting
this, by the
Jay,
time this
we'll hope
airs,
you're watching.
Yeah, by the time this airs, you know, you'll be on it.
Yeah,
so, and you'll have your own niche too. That's the thing. So, and you know, you mentioned that you love his vision. You know, and
it's like I had such good energy. Like when we talked, it was great.
Yeah,
I love that he helps, like, his trainers, and, like, just like the focus he's going. I think it's amazing.
Yeah, well, you'll be a part of it soon. Mm-hmm. So, Miss Shannon, by the way, there's her Instagram. Follow her. Thank you for being here at Connect with Christina, a.k.a.
The Cloud God.
Don't cheat.
It's a wrap.